Hello students, our today's topic is forecasting. So as you know, what do you mean by forecast? Forecast is a statement about the future. Means you are predicting what will happen in future, that is your forecast. How many types of forecast methods are there? If you are forecasting any demand which will be there in future, okay, how many methods are there to find this forecast? Primarily there are two methods, one is qualitative, second one is quantitative. Qualitative, there are no calculations, it's directly data taken from the market or data given by experts or data given by your executives. So there are different types of qualitative methods. One is executive opinion, second is market survey. Means you are going and doing survey in the market. Third is sales force. Depending on your sales, you are trying to find your future forecast. Sales meaning you will be having your sales persons, your distributors. You will try to find, take data and try to find about it. Then there is Delphi method. Delphi method means there are experts who give their opinion on the market. So this is qualitative, where there is no calculation or such of much. Okay, then second time is quantitative. In quantitative, there are two types of method. The first one is time series method and the second one is associative method. Time series method is used in different types of forecast. When the demand is random, when the demand is cyclical, when the demand is seasonal, when the demand is, there is some trend in the demand. So that time this time series method is used. Then there is associative model. Associative model means you are associating one thing with another to predict the future. So now let's start and let's see the time series method. Means to solve a time series method, there are different types of methods which are given. The first one is naive method. Second one is simple mean. Means you find the mean of the demand and you try to predict the forecast. The third one is simple moving average. Fourth one is weighted moving average. Fifth one is exponential smoothing. Then there is trend projection, which are used to find. Then there are seasonal indexes. Seasonal indexes are for the seasonal. Like for example, we can take umbrellas, which goes for sale mostly in rainy season. So it is a seasonal product. So that is seasonal indexes. So let's decompose this time series into different type. The first one, as we said, trend. You can see this graph over here. Okay, this is a linear graph which you can see. Means there is some trend of the product. It's going on increasing. Then the seasonality. Seasonal means you can see here. You can see this wave-like graph. Means year 1, year 2, year 3. Means there is demand in year 1. Again the demand goes down. Again when the year 2 comes, the demand increases. Then again the demand goes down. When the year 3 comes, again the demand increases. So this is type of seasonal, means yearly there is increase in demand at a certain period. Okay, then there is cyclical. Cyclical mostly is for many years or decades. Means you will try to find it out for 5 years, 10 years. So at around 5 years, the demand goes down. In next 5 years, the demand goes up. So it is for many years or decades. And the last one is, which we can see here, is random variation. Random means which is unpredictable. Anytime it demand might go up, anytime the demand might come down. So that is a type of random. So there is no exact prediction which you can do. So in random variation, mostly the prediction done in very close period. Like if you are planning to find a forecast for February, then you will try to take the forecast of January. So you will try to take the close periods for the random variation. So in type series, seen after decomposition, there is random variation, there is seasonal variation, there is trend variation, there is cycle variation. So we will take the random variation first in the time series. As you can see, I have drawn a graph again over here to show that this is a finding out for random variation. So now to find the random variation, which methods we can use? We had seen methods, right? Methods like Naive method, simple mean average method, simple moving average method, weighted moving average method, exponential smoothing, trend projection, seasonal indexes. These are different types of methods which we had seen. So which types of methods can be used to find a random variation? So first one, as we can see, is the naive method. Naive method, the formula is very simple over here. F of t is equal to a of t minus 1. So what is f of t over here? F of t is the forecast at a certain period which you are trying to predict. So you are trying to predict the forecast at some period of t. And a of t minus 1 means a means actual demand at certain period of time which you already know. For example, if you are trying to find forecast, if you are trying to find forecast for February, then what will be actual of a of t minus 1? So February will be t minus 1. So February minus 1 is January. So actual of January. So t minus 1 means February minus 1 is January. So f of, if you want to find forecast of February, you should know the actual of, actual demand of January. The second method which you use to find the random variation, which is a time series one, random variation forecasting. This next method which you use is simple mean average method. In this simple mean average method, to find the forecast of a certain period t, we should know the actual of previous periods. For example, if you want to find the forecast of May, you should know the forecast of at least previous few months, and you have to consider all those months to find the forecast in simple mean average method. For example, if you want to find, if you have data of January, February, data means you know the actual demand of this month, March, April, if you know demand of all this, if you know demand of all these months, and if you want to find the forecast for May, what it will be? It will be actual demand of January plus actual demand of February plus actual demand of March plus actual demand of April divided by how many months we have considered? 1, 2, 3, 4 divided by 4. Understood? So this way you can find the forecast using simple mean average method. The next method which is there is simple moving average method. In simple moving average method, it can be of different periods, like for 2 months, 3 months, or 1 year, 2 years, so on. So this 2 months, 3 months, you see this two. So this 2 months is called as two period. 3 months is called as three period, and it can go so on, 4 period, 5 period moving average. So here we have illustrated for two period. Moving average, then if you want to find a forecast for month May, if you want to find a forecast of month May, and they have told us it is 2 period moving average you have to find. Means you should know the actual demand of previous 2 months, that is April and March. So forecast for month May will be actual demand of April plus March divided by 2. Now if they tell you if you are considering the 3 period moving average, now they tell you you have to consider for 3 period, then if you want to find the forecast of month May, means you should know the actual demand of previous 3 months. So here you can see April, March and February. February, March, April. So 3 months previous actual demand you should know, that will be divided by 3. So this way we find a simple moving average method. The next method which is there is weighted moving average method. It is similar to the simple moving average method, but here there is inclusion of weightages for different months. So in this case we consider weighted average, means weightage is given for each period. If you are considering months, weightage will be given for each month. If you are considering year, weightage will be given for each year. For illustration purpose, we have taken if two period moving average, if two period weighted moving average you want to find. So that will be forecast for month May will be equal to actual of, now the 0.4 is a weightage given to month April and 0.3 is the weightage given to month March. And you can see there is no divided by 2 or divided by 3. So here it is just the weightage multiplied by month. So if you are finding the forecast for month May, it will be actual of demand of month April into the weightage plus actual of demand of month March multiplied by weightage. So you can notice here each month is given weightage depending on their importance. So months are given weightage depending on their importance. The last method which you can use to find a random variation is exponential smoothing. Exponential smoothing is, there is a formula for this where your alpha is your smoothing constant. You will be given a smoothing constant to find a forecast using exponential smoothing method. So your f of t is forecast at certain period where you want to find. Alpha is your exponential smoothing. A of t minus 1 means actual of demand. So this, if this t is January, this t minus 1 will be last December. Or if this t is February, A of t minus 1 can be January. Plus 1 minus alpha, f of t minus 1. F of t minus 1 will be what now? If this is February, this f of t minus 1 will be January. Okay, this is the exponential smoothing method. Now let's take an example to solve this method, solve these problems of random variation. So here we are given an example where we are given following data. So data is what? We are having data of last 5 months and what was demand in that last 5 months. So for period 1, the demand was 60 units. For period 2, the demand was 65 units. For period 3, the demand was 55 units. For period 4, the demand was 58 units. For period 5, the demand was 64 units. And what they are told to find? Prepare a forecast for period 6. Now you have data of actual data of period 5. Now they are telling to prepare a forecast for period 6 using each of these approaches. The first approach they are telling to find is by naive method. The second approach is by simple mean average method. The third approach is 3 period moving average method. Fourth approach is a weighted moving average. This is for 3 period. And they are given weights, that is 0.5 for most recent, 0.3 and then 0.2. And then lastly by exponential smoothing with smoothing constant of 0.40. So this is your alpha. So what I do, I plot this given the period and demand on a graph. So this is a period means time. The period means time. And this is demand which is given in the second column. So when you plot this, you will get some random graph. This is not a cyclical, or this is not a seasonal, or this is not some trend which is showing. This is some random graph if you can see. So since this graph shows a random variation, so we'll consider this problem as random type. So now let's solve this problem. Firstly, they told us to find by naive method. So let's use the naive method. So first method which we will use is naive method. And what is formula for naive method? F of t means which forecast you are finding is equal to actual of t minus 1. Now what they have told us to find? Forecast for period 6. You can see over here, prepare the forecast for period 6. The first case is naive method. So forecast for period f of 6 will be is equal to a of t is 6 minus 1. So f of 6 is equal to a of 6 minus 1 is 5. So what is actual of 5? You can see actual demand of 5 is 64. So forecast for, you can see here Actual for period 5 is 64. So actual for period 5 is 64. So f of 6 is equal to 64. So forecast for 6th period. Forecast for 6th period will be is equal to 64. Understood the naive method? This is simple naive method. Now the second which they have told, method which they have told, is to find by a simple mean average method. What we'll do over here? Now we have to find by simple mean average method. We have to find by simple mean average method. So what we know about simple mean average method? We have to take mean of the data which is available with us. So how many data are available? We have data of period 1, actual demand of period 1, actual demand of period 2, actual demand of period 3, period 4 and period 5. So we'll take mean of this data. So f of 6 will be is equal to a of 1 plus actual of 2 plus actual of 3 plus actual of 4 plus actual of 5 divided by how many data we are taking? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So divided by 5. So what is actual of 1? Actual of 1 if you see is 60, actual of 2 is 65, actual of 3 is 55, actual of 4 is 58, actual of 5 is 64. So we'll write the data over here. Actual demand for period 1 is 60. Actual demand of period 2 is 65. Actual demand of period 3 is 55 plus actual demand of period 4 is 58 plus actual demand of period 5 is 64 divided by 5. So if we calculate this, 302 divided by 5. So that will be is equal to 60.4, is approximately 61. So forecast for period 6 using simple mean average method will be is equal to 61. So this is the second method which we solved. Now if we see, the third way which they have told us to find is using a 3 period moving average method. 3 period. Please always look this in exam, what it is asked for. 3 period, 2 period, 4 period, 5 period. Depending on that, you have to solve the moving average method. So in the third case, it is moving average. So as we discussed before, how to solve a moving average problem? So now they ask for 3 period moving average. So we have to take data of last 3 months. If you are finding f of 6 if you are finding, which will come over here, and they have said 3 period. So you have to take data of last 3 months. So that will be is equal to actual of 5 plus actual of 4 plus actual demand of 3 divided by 3. So what is the actual demand of, what is actual demand of 5? Is 64. Actual demand of 4 is 58. Actual demand of 3 is 55 divided by 3. What value you will get? 77 divided by 3. So 177 divided by 3 will give you 59. So forecast for period 6 using moving average method will be is equal to 59. The next problem which we have to solve here is prepare forecast for period 6 using a weighted moving average for 3 period using weights 0.5, for most recent 0.3 and then 0.2. Most recent means the last demand which is there, then 0.3 for fourth demand and 0.2 for the third demand. Let's solve fourth problem, that is weighted moving average, and they have told us for three period. So the formula here will be forecast for period 6 will be is equal to 0.5, which is the weight given for the most recent, into this is the fifth period here, demand for fifth period is, we'll write actual demand for 5 first, plus 0.3 into actual demand of 4, plus 0.2 into actual demand of 3. So here it will be 0.5 into actual demand of 5 is what? 64, plus 0.3 into actual demand of 4 is 58, plus 0.2 into actual demand of 3 is 55. So if we solve this problem, we'll get 0.5 into 64, you'll get 32, 0.3 into 58, you'll get 17.4, plus 0.2 into 55, you'll get 11. If we add this up, it is 32 plus 17.4 plus 11. After adding this up, you'll get forecast for period 6 as 60.4. So f of 6, we have to round this up, that's f of 6 is equal to 61. Now the next problem which we have to solve here is prepare forecast for period 6 using these approaches. The last approach is exponential smoothing with smoothing constant of 0.4. So this 0.4 is a alpha. So here exponential smoothing, the fifth problem is using exponential smoothing. So the formula for exponential smoothing, as we know, f of period 6 is equal to alpha into actual of 6 minus 1 plus 1 minus alpha into forecast of 6 minus 1. So that will be is equal to alpha of actual of period 5 plus 1 minus alpha forecast of period 5. So now we know the actual demand of period 5, which is 64, and we know alpha, that is 0.4 into actual of period 5 is 64, plus 1 minus 0.4. Now we have to find your forecast. So how we'll find this forecast? We'll use again the naive method. So according to the naive method, how we find the forecast for period 5? Naive method, f of 5 is equal to a of 5 minus 1, that is a of 4. And what is a of 4? As you know, a of 4 is here is 58. So f of 5, this 58 will come over here. Now we have to solve 0.4 into 64 plus 0.6 into 58. If we calculate 0.4 into 64, you'll get 25.6 plus 0.6 into 58, you'll get 34.8. So if we add this both up, 25.6 plus 34.8, you'll get answer as 60.4. So f of 6 is equal to 60.4, we'll round this up to 61. So forecast using exponential smoothing method, you'll get f of 6 is equal to 61. So this is the end of our random variation. There are different methods we have used to find the random variation of time series method. So in the next part, we'll see the trend projection, how to solve for the trend projection in the time series method.